Student, in this lecture we will try to understand the concept of cash flows, meaning that in case if in any question cash flows are not given and you are trying to apply different methods to assess feasibility of the project. So this is important for you to understand that you cannot apply any method unless and until you have two information. One, what is the investment in the project and how much cash inflows you are receiving in the coming years of the project. To give you this idea, I'm showing you a question. See that in this question, you have an investment of 50,000. So this 50,000 is taken as cash outflow and various other informations are given. But question is giving you earning before tax. Earning before tax is not a cash flow, but this earning before tax can be used to calculate cash inflows. So whenever any other information is given, like sales, like operating profit, like net profit, or the way it is given right now, earning before tax, your first task is how to calculate cash inflows. In various other lectures, I will provide you support that in case if sales is given, then how you will convert it into cash inflows, etc. So today we are not applying these methods. We are simply converting this earning before tax into cash inflows. So for this, I'm going on another sheet of working one. See that in this worksheet, I'm taking all the 5 years which are given in your question. These are the 5 years that I'm taking. And these are the earning before tax information, which I'm simply selecting from here. So these are the earning before tax. Student, to calculate cash inflows from this earning before tax, first, on this amount you will apply tax rate. So earning before tax means these are the profit which are given before deducting tax. So in our question we have a tax rate of 40%, as you can see over here. So this 40% or whatever rate is given in question, you will apply this rate on earning before tax. So this earning before tax, I am taking this amount and calculating 40% on this amount. So the tax amount is coming 88,800. Student, the similar approach you can apply again. This is your profit before tax. You will apply 40% rate on this and your amount is 7,200. So now either you can apply one by one or you can simply drag it to get the amount. But whenever you will click on any column, you will see that it will show you the function of this amount. Student, net profit, I am supporting you here that when you are working on net profit, it means that you need two information, earning before tax and you will minus tax amount. So earning before tax is given here, tax amount you calculated, so now you can calculate net profit. To calculate net profit, we will take earning before tax and we will minus tax amount. So this is net profit. Again, see, I will take earning before tax minus tax amount. So the final answer is 10,800. And in this way, you will calculate net profit. Student, this is our main agenda. We are interested to calculate cash flows. To calculate cash flows, if earning before tax is given, then first you will calculate tax, then you will find out net profit, and then student, you will calculate depreciation. To calculate depreciation, check your question. As per question, your project machine investment is 50,000. Expected life of the machine is 5 years and there is no salvage value. It means we can apply a straight line method very easily to calculate annual depreciation. So for depreciation, student, we need two information. We will take cost, scrap will be minus, divided by life. Since we do not have a scrap value, so we will take only the cost of the machine and divided by the life. So the resulting depreciation is 10,000. It means, student, we can apply this 10,000 depreciation. Since this is a straight line method, so you don't need to change it. You can simply copy this information. Student, this is the focus point of our today's lecture. So if you are interested to calculate cash flow, first see that what is the formula to calculate cash flow. Student, cash flow will come net profit plus depreciation. So we already have net profit. We computed depreciation. If we add these two information, then we will get cash flow. Again, see, this is your net profit. You will add depreciation in it and your cash flow amount will come. So to calculate cash flow, you need two main informations. One, net profit, and the second one is depreciation. If you face any problem, then you can discuss me on other resources where we can sort out these issues. I'll give you practice material just to attempt your question up to here. Once your confidence will develop how to calculate cash flow, then we will move to various methods and wait for my next video on this topic. Thank you.